Hey everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Dungeon Hack Redux, Episode 3. I'm Duke of the Bump, a chaotic good cleric. We just made it to level 3 of the dungeon. We previewed level 3 briefly when I fell in a pit on level 2, not paying attention to my surroundings. But fortunately I had a grappling hook, so I was able to clear out level 2 before advancing. I probably would have been okay, but you know, if you fight monsters before you're ready, then it might not work out for you. I think we're having a pretty good pretty good run so far. What the heck was that? Giant rat? Oh, it was a were-rat. Cool. The thing about were-rats is, like were-wolves, they can only be defeated by certain types of weapons. In D&D lore, I don't know if silver weapons are a thing in D&D lore for lycanthropes, but I know that magical weapons definitely work against them. Man, they tried to trap me in there with all those bugbears. That wasn't cool, man. Alright, so I'm taking these bugbears out a lot more easily than the one I fought on level 1. I don't think there's anything else special about were-rats. Crap. They hurt a little bit. Took a bit of damage there. Cornelian. I'm assuming that's just another kind of key. Although I don't think I've seen that specific key before. I should probably equip my shield again. That would help me out a bit. Give me that bump to my armor class. The music is the soundtrack to the game Chrono Cross. I know I fall back on the soundtrack a lot, or at least I did when I was streaming Spelunky. But I can't help it. It's just such a great soundtrack. And, you know, it's one of the best fantasy-themed soundtracks I've ever listened to, so playing a fantasy-themed game, it seemed appropriate. Oh, Lord. So I had kind of an unsettling a surprising, little worrying conversation with Kostya, the guy who requested this game during the donation drive. And he was surprised that I decided to play a moderate difficulty game instead of an easy one, because his request, I don't know if he specified in his request, but I indicated that I would be playing a relatively short, you know, easy run through a dungeon hack. But then, when I actually started playing the game again, I decided, you know, I'm not going to take the coward's way out. I'm going to dive in and, you know, I'll be okay. I've played a video game or two in my time. At least that was my reasoning. But Kostya, he gave me some advice about this game. And unfortunately, it's too late for me to follow that advice. From what he was saying, after level 8, this game gets pretty unbalanced. Let's see, what do I need to cast again? 8, I guess? No. I was already under the influence of an 8 spell. That's weird, my HP bar was green instead of blue. I don't have prayer memorized at the moment, so I'll just use a bless. So, from what he was saying, after level 8, dungeon level 8, not character level 8, oh, now it expires, the game starts getting a little repetitive. It draws from the same pool of monsters after that point, and they're all extremely difficult, and it's also a lot harder to go up levels after you make it to that point. So, he was more worried that I would get bored than not being able to continue. Which, you know, it's quite possible. Neither fire nor cold-based spells inflict much damage on the water weird. You'd think cold would be effective against water. You know, it would freeze it and turn it to ice, but I guess I'm thinking in Final Fantasy terms, not D&D terms. So yeah, it's quite possible that after level 8 or so, I'm just going to be rushing my way through the levels since there's no point in me actually fighting stuff if I can no longer level up after that point. I don't know. I'll have to wait and see. I mean, he suggested just starting over and doing a shorter dungeon run. Here's what I should have done. I should have... Oh, that's that thing that I picked up. The garnet. Okay. I should have kept the moderate difficulty settings, but played a shorter dungeon. I should have kept it at 10. But, you know, had all the monster difficulty and stuff turned up. See, I was worried that if I did that, then that would unbalance the game, because the heck goes here? Oh, I see. Okay. It's a thing in the middle there. Because I was worried that if I played moderate, but it didn't have 18 levels, it would start throwing all the high-level stuff at me earlier, and I wouldn't be able to handle it. I should probably heal up a little bit. So that's why I kept it at 18, because honestly, I never made it that far in this game before. I didn't know how things became balanced after that point. So yeah, it sounds like level 8 or so is the tipping point, from what he was saying. And, you know, I take his word for it, he probably knows more about this game than I do. So it's possible that at that point, I will have to change my playstyle slightly. Also, if things do start getting hairy, I might... Why do I suppose these are here? Well, I guess I'm supposed to hang something from them, but I sure don't know what. Oh, crap. You snuck up on me, you rat bastard. So it's possible that if things start getting hairy, I might have to abandon my only save at the beginning of a floor rule and start doing... more quick saves. I don't know if I'll get to that point. Just a heads up. If it comes down to dying over and over again or having to use quick saves, then I'll go with the quick saves. Scroll of Bless. Not really necessary, but I'll take it. Also, if things start getting like stressful or frustrating or whatever, it's possible that I'll take a break from this and play some more Mario or do something else just to kind of take a breather from Dungeon Hack. Of course, I'm giving all these disclaimers. I have no idea if any of these will actually be necessary, so I'll try to have faith in myself to complete this. Really wish I could just put the shield in that slot so I wouldn't have to think about it. Just replace the holy symbol when I need to. Oh well, I guess it's not that big of a deal. Crap. Oh, that was my detect magic spell expiring. Well, it'd be nice if there was like a hotbar or something that I could assign spells to, so I can just hit 3 to cast detect magic again when I need it, or you know, hit 2 to cast aid again, hit 1 to cast flame blade again. But no, it was a simpler time in video games. Why not? I have all these coins. You know, I'm a little surprised that there's not more emphasis on the keyboard in this game. It's almost entirely mouse driven. I mean, you can play this game without using the keyboard at all. Just use the mouse to use these arrows. It's not the preferable way of playing, but it's definitely possible. And the keyboard is only used as a replacement for these. That's the only thing it's for. There's not even a key to use the item in your hands. Like, I figured you could hit like control to use item 1 or space to use item 2 or something, but nope. Just the arrows. Where am I going? Okay. One nice thing about being a cleric is that with the create food and water spell, I can essentially just grind enemies indefinitely, and I never have to worry about running out of food. So if things do get really desperate, I can always just like record a video off screen a little bit before I continue. I don't want to sling. And basically grind out some levels. I don't know. I mean, it might take a little bit of time, but and I might switch to Mario for a bit or switch to something else for a bit, and in the meantime, just, you know, walk around fighting stuff over and over again, because monsters do infinitely respawn. I'm pretty sure there's no way to actually clear out my flame blade expired. There's no way to actually clear out a dungeon, so theoretically I could just walk around killing stuff forever. And you know, I don't really mind grinding in games like this, because I can do that while I listen to podcasts or listen to other LPs or streams. So if I have to, I will. Hopefully I won't have to, though. Okay, I don't need Bless now that I have Prayer, so I will get another Cure Light Wounds, and I don't really need Detect Magic at the moment, so I'll just take 5 of those. I don't know why I got Slow Poison. I don't really need that yet, so I'll take another Flame Blade. I might start using Spiritual Hammer, because from what I understand, it gets more powerful the higher level you are. And then level 3, still don't need Create Food and Water just yet, so I'll take 2 prayers for now. I still have Iron Rations, and those give you quite a bit of food. I love that sound effect. I wish I made that sound effect every time I ate food. I mean, I could if I wanted to. Other people around me might not appreciate it, though. One of my favorite podcasts is the Insert Credit Podcast. And 2 of the regulars on that show have a condition. And it's an actual, like, thing. I don't know if it's a phobia or what. But the sound of people eating makes them extremely uncomfortable, which I thought was interesting. If you ever played the game Frog Fractions, it has an option to disable eating noises. And the developer of that game put that in there specifically for one of the people on that podcast. His name is Brandon, and he's friends with the guy who made Frog Fractions, and he put that option in just for him, which I thought was pretty sweet. I like the sound of people eating. I don't know. Especially when it's like very... I mean, not like people sloppily eating food and, you know, smacking their lips and all that, but like crunching and, you know, the little gulp noise it makes. You know, it's not like realistic, but I don't know. I enjoy it. I should probably use some of these buffs, huh? Since I'm missing at least 2 out of 3 attacks. Jesus, these guys still hurt. Wow. Maybe I spoke too soon about being able to take these guys out more easily. Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, crap. I can't let myself... I let myself get trapped. Okay. Whew. Man. I have to say, this is going a lot more poorly than my moderate practice run went, because you saw in the save screen I had up to level 5 saved, and I made it to that point without breaking a sweat. These enemies weren't nearly as hard. I did find, in that playthrough, I did find Bracers of Giant Strength, which gave me a strength of 22, but still, well, I guess that is a pretty big difference, because I have, what, 16 now? I guess I shouldn't have used that run as my example of what a typical moderate run is. Oh, I saw the blue dot. I was like, what the heck? Where is that item? So if you have any suggestions for music for me to listen to during these, make them in the comments, because I was actually kind of struggling to think of something else to listen to. I mean, I don't want to listen to nothing but Final Fantasy music, like I did, and ooh, these look like good gauntlets to have. I'll go ahead and use them, and if they're cursed, I will, I'll pray for remove curse. Okay, my armor class is 4. My armor class is 5, so slight boost to my armor class. Of course, these have some sort of magical effect, but I don't know what they do. So, I guess better to stick with the devil I know than the devil I don't know. This is an ornamental mallet. It's purely decorative. It's just for hitting gongs with. I was watching another guy's LP of this. There's someone else on YouTube doing this game at the same time I am. And he was listening to the Conan the Barbarian soundtrack. I feel like spiders are crawling all over. I still don't know what that does. Might not do anything. Might just be there to psych me out. But man, that is a really good soundtrack. The only problem with it was it got flagged for copyright status by YouTube. So his videos all had ads on them. And I don't want that to happen. This must be, oh, well, I was there before. I must not have had the right key at the time. Oh, the spidery feeling went away. Huh. That's so weird. I mean, it doesn't, like, there's nothing showing up different in my stats, so I don't know what it does. Maybe it makes it, just gives me a penalty to hit because I'm distracted or something. Oh, come on. I didn't want to do the dance with you because you're just a were-rat. I shouldn't be missing this often. Maybe that's exactly what the spiders do. Apparently it's this whole area. That's happening a lot. Oh, you know what? That's just a decorative thing. I thought maybe it might be a special kind of lock, but no, that's just a flavor thing. Man, bugbears all over this freaking place. Dang it. I wish there was a way to see what effects I currently had on me, because I don't know why, sometimes your HP bar shows up as blue when you cast aid, and sometimes it doesn't. My theory was that it only shows up as blue when you have above the maximum number of hit points, but I don't think that's the case. Alright, let's pray some more. So I don't know. I'm stumped. Alright. Making pretty good progress on level 3. So, I haven't played any more Etrian Odyssey since the last time I recorded these. Flesh Golem? Ugh. I don't want to see what that guy looks like. If anyone who's watching is familiar with the, I keep forgetting to re-equip my shield, is familiar with the Etrian Odyssey series, tell me what I should do, because I'm enjoying the demo for Etrian Odyssey Untold, which is the remake of the original Etrian Odyssey for the DS. I'm enjoying it, but everyone, like, I've looked up reviews and stuff, and everyone says that I should get Etrian Odyssey 4 instead, because it's way better. So if anyone watching has an opinion of those two games, Etrian Odyssey 4 or Etrian Odyssey Untold, which one should I go for? Because, I mean, it's kind of cool playing, like, you know, I don't want to jump in the middle of the series with 4, even though it probably, I don't think the storylines really have continuity or anything. But, you know, it's kind of cool to start from the beginning, so to speak. So yeah, any opinions are appreciated. Honestly, I really haven't had that much time for extracurricular gaming recently. Work has still been a nightmare, but, well, I shouldn't say nightmare. My job's so easy. I really feel bad complaining about it, even when I am working, you know, 50 to 60 hours a week. If any of you are fans of that Mitchell and Webb look, the sketch comedy show starring David Mitchell and Robert Webb, there's a sketch where one of them, I forget which one, works at like, it's been a while, so I forget the details, but he works at like an orphanage for sick, you know, disabled children or something, and then the roommates, Mitchell and Webb, and the other one works at an ice cream factory. So the guy who works at the ice cream factory comes home, and they're just complaining about their jobs to each other. And the guy who works with sick children is like, "Yeah, I had to watch another one be put down today. It was pretty heart-wrenching. How was your day?" And he was like, "Oh, well, I had to taste like 10 different kinds of vanilla. It was so boring. I mean, why is there so much vanilla?" I mean, I'm paraphrasing, but that's sort of what the gist of the skit was. Oh God. And I kind of feel like the guy who works as a taste tester at the ice cream factory, because my job, I mean, it's not like, I mean, it's not tasting ice cream, but you know, I can keep myself entertained by listening to podcasts and audiobooks and stuff all day, which is great. And I sit at a desk. I don't have to, you know, stand all day like I did when I worked at a gas station. So I have it pretty great. And of course, once the overtime pay actually starts showing up on my paychecks, then I'll be a very happy camper. But that won't happen until the next one. Man, I need to figure out a way to get my Thaco up. By the way, if you're not a D&D nerd and you're wondering what the heck I'm talking about, Thaco stands for chimes. It stands for to hit armor class 0, THAC 0. And remember how I said a lower armor class is better? Well, 0 is a very good armor class, and your Thaco, you know, there's a chart that you go by, and whatever your Thaco is determines your ability to hit. So say your Thaco is 18, that means in order to hit someone with an armor class of 0, you'll need to roll an 18 on a 20-sided die. And that's the stat that you use in combat. And your Thaco is affected by, you know, the quality of your weapon, any bonuses it might have, and a number of other factors, any buff spells that you cast on yourself. And this game doesn't give you any sort of indication about that. You just kind of have to use whatever weapons you want and see what works. I don't know what these chimes do. I seem to remember reading something about chimes of opening, which can open a locked door, but there was another kind of chimes, and I don't remember what that one was. I should probably wait until I get something that can identify them before I start ringing them willy-nilly. Because they might, like, I don't know, alert monsters to my presence or something. I mean, not that they aren't already alerted to my presence, you know. Because they're all over the freaking place. How could they not be? Oh, I didn't even realize this was a lock. I thought this was a decoration. Well, I don't have what goes there anyway. Oops. Okay, what about this door? Oh, man. That's like a teleporter or something, isn't it? I don't know if I want to step in there. Oh, for Pete's sake, just hit something. Maybe I should have been a fighter cleric. Aw, man. Quit moving. I don't know, though. When you're a fighter cleric, both of your classes start out at level 2 instead of level 4. And like I was saying, they take twice as long to level up because you have to split the experience between the two. So, I don't know. I mean, I'd be better hitting stuff, but it would have been way longer until I get, like, create food and water and stuff like that. And remove curse. Having removed curse this early has definitely been... Oh, crap. It's a sheet ghoul. I should have said, oh, sheet. It's a sheet ghoul. That would have been more apropos. But yeah, basically, sheet ghoul is just a tougher version of the regular ghoul. I don't think it has any like special attacks or anything. It can hold you, quote unquote, paralyzed. Oh yeah, it has like some sort of acid spitting attack. Oh man, I got a good hit in on him. Oh man, he spit at me before I went through the teleporter. This is not looking good. In my practice run, I killed the sheet ghoul, like, no problem. Like, a couple hits. Oh my god, how many hit points does this guy have? Maybe that was my easy practice run. I'm pretty sure I was playing on moderate, though. Oh. My. God. Oh, thank Lord. Thank Lord. Just the one. And I got rations and a staff. Great. Unless it's like a super awesome staff of smiting plus 10. I thought I killed you. Topaz potion. Do I already have one of those? Yeah. Oh wait, was that... Oh, that was the same one. Never mind. Nope, that's the only topaz potion I have. Oh well. Ah. Oh, I'm glad I decided to look for secret passages there. Illusionary walls. Okay, is there anything else I want to do on this level? There's like a tiny corner up there. How long would it take me to get back there? Not too long, but there's going to be monsters in the way. There's a bunch of monsters in here as well. I really hate not exploring everything on a map, so forgive my OCD tendencies. That's actually not a cool thing to say, because people who actually have OCD, it's a pretty it's a pretty serious thing. It's probably not a good idea to make light of it. I mean, Olalilia has very severe OCD. Oh man, it's the spider corridor again. And it affects his life in some pretty profound ways. Like, he does not have the ability to... Like, he can't walk past a mirror. Because of his OCD, like, it messed up his life. Speaking of Olalilia, he just posted like a 2-hour video for the five-year anniversary of Platform Masters, the game he's developing, and it was quite a watch. You know what? That looks very suspicious. Ah. My explorer's intuition paid off, because there was no other way to get to this section because it was blocked off. So I figure there must be a secret passage around there somewhere. Oh no. Pr- probably getting close to time to rest. But yeah, if you're not familiar with Ulalilia, it's U-L, the word ill twice, I-L-L-I-L-L-I-A. And he's working on this game called Platform Masters because he really loves 2D platformers, as do I. And it has like, oh god, I am getting so low on health. I need to lick my wounds. Is that far enough away? Okay, great. But the game has like 50 layers of parallax scrolling, and it's just insane levels of detail in the environments. And you know, he's not like a, he's not like an artist or anything, but you know, he does the best he can with the abilities he has. And it just looks really cool. I can't wait till it's done. And he also posts gameplay videos as well, but it's typically showing ways to break RPGs in really profound ways. He really loves maxing out high scores, like getting the highest score you possibly can, getting the numbers up to as many nines. Hey, I'm level 6, awesome. As many nines as you can fit. Like, he played the game Disgaea, the turn-based strategy RPG thing, and that's a very bad game for OCD people to play. Or good. I mean, I guess he enjoyed it, but he spent a lot of time getting the characters up to level 9,999, so they can each do 99 billion points of damage with every attack. Alright, I have, well, there's probably nothing in that room. But yeah, my point is, don't say you're OCD because you're probably not. Unless you are, then, you know, then that's cool. Wait. Okay. Yeah, I don't know what it is about that hallway. Every time I walk in that area, I feel like there are spiders crawling on me. Oops. Hi, buddy. Man, what's with everyone dual wielding? The bugbear has 2 axes, the were-rat has 2 swords. I can't dual wield. Speaking of wielding, though, I need to put like a post-it on top of my monitor that just says, switch back to your shield, because I'm never going to remember that. That's weird. I bet that opens the one door I haven't opened. Where is it? Right there. But it doesn't matter because I've already been on both sides of that door. So I just need to go up, then left, then down, then right. This is a fountain, by the way. Long unused, now only holds a thick layer of dust. You know, I don't know how the monsters are surviving in this dungeon. There's no water or anything. I mean, I guess they can just all eat each other. But you wouldn't think that would be enough to keep them all alive. All right, nothing else. Okay. Hey. See, where the heck did? Minor rant. I really don't like it when games do that. Just have monsters perpetually respawn like that. I like the feeling of being able to clear out a level of a dungeon. Of course, then you couldn't do what I was saying, where you grind for enemies to power up. But still, you should be able to clear out a level of a dungeon and then reset the enemies if you want to. That would be ideal for me. But enough of my rantry. We're on level 4. Yay! Oh yeah, I'm level 6. I should probably take a look at my spells and see what else I can get now. Alright, still 5 of those, still 5 of those. I have 1 extra level 3 spell now. Probably going to start needing negative plane protection pretty soon. And create food and water pretty soon. But for now, I'll just stick with prayer because that's It's the only thing I need at the moment, and no level 4 spells yet. Alright, and that'll about do it for this episode of Let's Play Play Dungeon Hack Redux. I'm Duke of the Bump. Tune in on Monday. Got my days mixed up a little bit. For level 4. Should be fun. Hopefully things don't start getting progressively more and more brutal, and I can make it through this dungeon. Save my game. See you guys later.